Friends, today I will discuss about the second part, that is etiology of the tumor or causes of tumor formation. Then first, before going into the etiology, incidence of the cancers. Cancer is one of the most common diseases in the developed world, and it is 1 in 4 to 5 deaths are due to cancers. That it accounts for 20 to 25% causes of death. 1 in 17 death are due to lung cancer, and lung cancer is the commonest, most common cancer in the men previously, but now the prostatic carcinoma has gone up, and the incidence of prostate cancer is most common in the world, and then the lung cancer comes next. Then breast cancer is most common in the world in case of females. And in India, the incidence of carcinoma cervix is highest, and breast cancer is next to carcinoma cervix. There are over 1,000 different forms of cancer. The incidence worldwide, cancer accounts for 20% of all death due to cancer, 20 to 25%. Even United States, second most common cause of death next to heart disease. The most common cancers in the developed world are prostate, then lungs, then breast, then colorectal. Prostate in males and breast in females, then lung cancer and colorectal cancer. In the developing countries, most common is oral and esophageal cancers. Next common is lungs, then prostate, then colorectal, then cervix, breast in case of females, and liver also. The geographic and environmental factors are sun exposure, melanomas, about 6 times incidence in New Zealand as compared to Iceland. Blacks have lower incidence of melanoma. Smoking and alcohol abuse are associated with the cancers. Then body mass. Increased body mass is associated with the cancer. Similarly, overweight accounts for 50% increase in cancer. Then environmental versus racial factors are also important in cancer causation. Then Japanese immigrants to USA also accounts for certain factors of the cancers. Then the most common cancer in the world in the men are prostate. Oral cavity in the India is most common, then comes prostate, then lungs, then colorectal carcinoma, then urinary bladder and melanoma. In females, most common cause is cervix, carcinoma cervix in India. Then most common cause is breast cancer, then lungs, then colorectal carcinoma, then endometrial carcinoma, thyroid and hypopharynx, etc. In children under 20 years of age, most common cancers are acute leukemia, then brain tumors like gliomas, then lymphomas, then bone sarcomas like Ewing's sarcoma and soft tissue sarcoma. Then predisposing or epidemiological factors for cancer causations are the common cause of the cancers are divided into 2 broad groups. First is predisposing factors or epidemiological risk factors, and second is precipitating factors or carcinogenetic factors. Amongst the predisposing factors or epidemiological risk factors of the cancers are endogenous or constitutional or host factors, and exogenous or environmental factors. In precipitating factors encompasses exogenous agents like physical carcinogen, chemical carcinogen and biological carcinogen. Carcinogen is any agent that causes cancer is carcinogen. Now coming to the age, the predisposing factors are age. Most cancers occur in older subjects above 55 years of the age. The childhood cancers like leukemia, gliomas, CNS neoplasm, bone tumors like Ewing sarcoma and blastoma like retinoblastoma, neuroblastoma, hepatoblastoma, then your nephroblastoma occurs in children. Then sex, certain tumors are more common in particular sex, either male or female. Like sex factors, in males, most common cancers are prostate, oral cancers, lungs, and colorectal cancers. In female, the breast, then cervix, carcinoma cervix comes to number one cause of cancer in the India, then comes the breast cancer, then lungs cancer, then colorectal carcinoma, then gallbladder cancers, then your thyroid cancers, then hypopharynx cancers. The racial factors, white Europeans and Americans like lung, breast and colorectal. Blacks have lung, liver, prostate and penis cancers are more common in blacks. That is, lungs, liver, prostate and penis cancer are common in blacks. Similarly, in Japanese, carcinoma stomach is 5 times more common in blacks as compared to Japanese as compared to Americans. This carcinoma stomach is more common in, particularly associated with the rice, is common in case of Japanese as compared to Americans. Then Southeast Asian region, especially in Chinese, nasopharyngeal carcinoma is most common. Then Indians, oral, upper aerodigestive tract tumors, liver due to hepatitis B or hepatitis C virus, and in the females, carcinoma cervix and breast are more common cancers in the Indians. Then heredity or genetic factors like retinoblastoma, familial polyposis coli or adenomatous polyposis coli or multiple endocrine neoplasia are having genetic association or hereditary factors associated with the cancers. Then predisposing factors or epidemiological risk factors, amongst the endogenous factors are age, sex, race, heredity. And exogenous factors are fifth, environmental and cultural factors and certain precursor lesions of the cancers. Amongst the age, sex, race and heredity are endogenous factors, and two, environmental and precursor lesion are exogenous factors. Now coming to age, most common in the older subjects above 55 years of age. In children accounts for 2% of the cancers like leukemia, blastoma like retinoblastoma, hepatoblastoma, nephroblastoma, adenoblastoma, then neuroblastoma. These accounts for 2% cases. Bone tumors like Ewing sarcoma also common, and CNS tumors like gliomas are more common in children. Amongst the benign tumors, the many of the benign tumors seen in infancy and childhood are actually growth of the dispersed cells or masses from tissue and their from the tissues and their proliferation therein, like hematomas. As I have told you, hematomas are developmental tumor like malformation composed of tissues indigenous to the part but lacking the growth potential of true neoplasm. The common example of hematomas are your hemangioma, glomangioma, then tuberous sclerosis and nevus. These are the hematomatous lesion. Hematomas are a developmental tumor-like malformation composed of tissue indigenous to the part but lacking the growth potential of true neoplasm. Then choriostoma or heterotopia. These are choriostoma or heterotropia or cancer collection of normal cells at abnormal sites like pancreatic tissue in the digestive tract, similarly other tissue. So these are and tumors arising from that pancreas in the digestive are called example of choriostoma or heterotopia. Then malignant tumors in infants and children under the 4 years of age are most common malignant tumors of various kinds. As I have told you, the like various blastomas are common in certain nephroblastoma, hepatoblastoma are common under the age of 4 years of age. And in the 10 to 14 years, bone cancer like Ewing sarcoma are more common in 10 to 14 years of the age, or acute leukemia also. Then common benign tumors occurring in children are hemangioma, lymphangioma, glomangioma, sacrococcygeal teratoma, then fibromatosis, then tumor like lesions like nevocellular nevi, liver cell adenoma and your rhabdomyoma. Then malignant tumors, hemopoietic, age less than 44 years of age, acute leukemia, 5 to 9 years leukemia, acute leukemia and lymphoma, and about 10 to 14 years of age, Hodgkin's disease. Then blastoma, less than 4 years of age, hepatoblastoma, retinoblastoma, neuroblastoma, are common pulmonary, bronchopulmonary dysplasia are common in less than 4 years of age. Then 5 to 9 years, neuroblastoma and hepatocellular carcinoma are common in 5 to 9 years of age. And above 10 to 14 years, that is 10 to 14 years of age, hepatocellular carcinoma. Then soft tissue rhabdomyosarcoma, less than 4 years of age. Then 5 to 9 years, soft tissue sarcoma. Then 10 to 14 years of age, soft tissue sarcoma. Then bony lesions, Ewing's tumors, 5 to 9 years of age, and 10 to 14 years of age are osteogenic sarcoma. Then neural, like CNS tumors, gliomas are common in less than 9 years and for less than 4 years of age also. And others less than 4 years of age are teratoma, and 10 to 15 years of age are thyroid carcinoma. Then sex distribution. Certain tumors are common in particular sex, either male or females. In the males, most common tumors are prostate, oral cavity, oral cancers, lungs, and colorectal carcinoma are more common. In the females, breast tumor, carcinoma cervix in Indian, number one cancer. Then lungs, colorectal carcinoma, gallbladder carcinoma, thyroid cancer, and hypopharynx cancers are more common in females. This is about the various incidence of cancers. In the males, prostate accounts most common, 21%. Then lungs, next to prostate, accounting for 14%. In the females, carcinoma cervix is more common, and breast is next, that is 20% of the breast cancer, and 19 after that breast cancer, lungs carcinoma or lung cancer is more common. Similarly, death occurring by most common is cancer death are due to lung cancer in males, and in the females most common cancer is breast. Then race. White Europeans and Americans, lung, breast and colorectal carcinoma is more common in white European and Americans. In the blacks, liver, lungs, prostate and penis cancer are more common. In the Japanese, carcinoma stomach is 5 times more common than Americans. Then Southeast Asian region, like in Chinese, nasopharyngeal carcinoma is more common. In Indians, upper aerodigestive tract tumors. Then liver cancer due to hepatitis B and hepatitis C viral infections. In Indian females, carcinoma cervix due to papilloma, human papilloma virus, and breast carcinoma due to Bittner's milk factor are most common in Indians. So this is about the racial distribution of the various cancers. Then heredity or genetic factor, genetic predisposition or heredity occurs at early age of onset, two or more primary relatives with the cancer, multiple or bilateral tumors and polymorphism that metabolize procarcinogens, that is nitrites, are associated with the cancer. So hereditary factors, the cancers are more common hereditary factor associated with certain genes like autosomal dominant mode of inheritance occurs in retinoblastoma, melanoma, familial adenomatosis polypi, neurofibromatosis 1 and neurofibromatosis 2, then breast cancer and ovarian tumors, then multiple endocrine neoplasia. Then autosomal recessive cancers, that is autosomal recessive cancers are geroderma pigmentosa in the skin, ataxia telangiectasia in case of neural tumors, and Bloom's syndrome and Fanconi's anemia. These are autosomal recessive tumors. Then familial clustering. The familial cancers are certain like breast cancers, ovarian cancers and pancreatic cancers occur in certain families. So these are not associated with the autosomal dominant or recessive mode of incidence, but familial clustering has been seen in case of breast cancer, ovarian cancer and pancreatic cancer. Then certain cancer associated with the gatekeeper gene and caretaker gene. Amongst the gatekeeper gene are adenomatous polyposis coli syndrome, retinoblastosis associated with the P53 antigen, neurofibromatosis 1 and neurofibromatosis 2. So these are all autosomal dominant disorders, as I have told you. And certain autosomal recessive disorders are defect of caretaker gene mutation, like your ataxia telangiectasia, then Bloom syndrome, then your geroderma pigmentosa are autosomal recessive disorders associated with the your caretaker gene mutation disorders. Then environmental and cultural factors, exogenous factors, predisposing exogenous factors like cigarette smoking associated with the lung cancer or urinary bladder, kidney and digestive tract tumors. Then alcohol abuse is also associated with the cancers. Then synergistic interaction of alcohol and tobacco is associated with the cancers. Then cancer of the cervix associated with the early age of first coitus. Then frequency of the coitus. Then multiple partners and increased parity are associated with the cancer cervix. Then penile cancers, the ethical reason, there is a circumcision in case of Muslims. So Muslim gets carcinoma penis less as compared to Indians due to reason of the circumcision, because smegma acts as a carcinogen. So in the Muslims, the penile cancer is less common. Then betel nut cancer, oral cancer due to chronic irritation, areca nuts or supari in Indians it is called, very much commonly used in the by Indians, particularly Biharis and Uttar Pradesh, and associated with the oral cancers. Then large number of industrial and environmental factors like occupational diseases. Then certain constituent of the diet like deficiency of the vitamin A, zinc, vitamin C, molybdenum associated with the increased incidence of cancer. So these are the environmental and cultural factors. Then occupational factors like arsenic workers in arsenic and working with arsenic or arsenic compound in asbestos factory workers, similarly in beryllium workers, then cadmium, chromium working factory working workers are associated with the cadmium is associated with prostatic carcinoma and chromium associated with the lung cancers. Then nickel, lung carcinoma associated, radon associated with the lung carcinoma, then vinyl chloride associated with the your hepatic carcinoma, hepatocellular carcinoma and angiosarcoma. Then certain precursor lesions are associated. Amongst the exogenous predisposing factors are non-hereditary predisposing conditions, precancerous lesion like geroderma pigmentosa, solar keratosis, erythroplasia of keratin. In case of penis, your chronic inflammation like ulcerative colitis associated with the cancers, your atrophic gastritis or pernicious anemia is associated with the cancer of the stomach. Then leukoplakia of the mucous membrane, particularly oral leukoplakia, is associated with the oral cancer. Then immunodeficiency stress like T cell deficiency and in lymphoma and carcinoma in HIV AIDS patients and HIV AIDS associated with the Kaposi sarcoma also. Certain acquired pre-malignant conditions, I have told you, a skin like actinic keratosis, third degree burn, marginal ulcer, dysplastic nevus and geroderma pigmentosa. GIT tumor are leukoplakia, Barrett's esophagus, that is intestinalization of the lower end of the esophagus, that is squamous cell carcinoid, squamous cell are replaced by intestinal layer, that is Barrett's esophagus, it is a columnar cell, it is a precancerous conditions, then ulcerative colitis, then villus or tubulovillus adenoma, then liver, your regenerative nodule and hepatic cirrhosis, hepatitis B virus infection or C virus infections are associated with the liver cancer. So these are the pre-malignant conditions. Similarly, in respiratory tract, squamous dysplasia of the bronchi associated with usually due to inhalation of the smoke of the smoking. Then female genital tract, like vaginal adenosis, cervical intraepithelial neoplasia type 3 and endometrial hyperplasia and hydatidiform mole. In the breast, mammary ductal atypical hyperplasia, and in the blood, myelodysplastic syndrome is associated. So these are the pre-malignant conditions of the conditions of skin, GIT, liver, respiratory, female genital tract, breast and blood. So chronic inflammatory states like I have told you asbestosis, bronchitis, cystitis in bladder, then fungal growth, then inflammatory bowel disorders, lichen sclerosis, chronic pancreatitis, hepatobiliary pancreatitis, then sialadenitis are associated, Sjögren's syndrome are associated with the cancers, and infectious origin like chronic cholecystitis, then your hepatitis, viral hepatitis B and C, then AIDS. So these are the certain conditions, chronic inflammatory states associated with the cancers. Now precipitating factors. Among the precipitating factors are exogenous factors, and amongst the exogenous factors or carcinogens are physical factors, chemical factors and biological factors. Amongst the physical carcinogens are radiational and non-radiational. Radiational, ultraviolet radiation, ionizing radiations due to X-ray, alpha ray, beta ray, gamma rays, radioactive isotopes, protons and neutrons. Higher dose and with high linear energy transfer associated with the carcinogenic effect, like linear energy accelerator. Then non-radiational continuous mechanical injury like a stone in the gallbladder associated with the squamous cell metaplasia, that is cuboidal and columnar cell are replaced by squamous cell. Similarly, mechanical injury by the arachnoids or sometimes chotta cancer is used in Assam or China. The lightened end of the cigarette is kept in the mouth and smoke is thrown outside. Similarly, in Assamese, there is Kangri cancer. Due to extensive cold, the earthen pot is binded or kept in the stomach to heat up the body. So Kangri cancer is associated with the cancer of the skin in the abdominal region due to chronic irritation. Then non-radiational, amongst the chronic irritation, like I have told you, Kangri cancer, chotta cancer or stone. Then implants of inert material like plastic, glass and prosthesis are also associated with the physical carcinogenesis, physical carcinogens. Then radiational, amongst the radiational carcinogens, ultraviolet light causes squamous cell carcinoma, basal cell carcinoma and multiple myeloma. Ionizing radiations like photons and particulates, hematopoietic and thyroid tumors in atomic fallout victims. Hematopoietic and thyroid cancer is more common than your solid tumors, either less susceptible or require longer latency than leukemia and lymphoma. Basal cell carcinoma occurs in therapeutic radiation also. So these are the radiational carcinogenesis. Then chemical carcinogens or chemical factors. In the chemical factors, there is an initiator and promoter. Initiator, induction of mutation. The promoter are not mutagenic. The dose of initiator single for a short period. The promoters repeated dose for long period. Then response, sudden response in initiators and in gradual response or slow response in case of promoters. The change is permanent and irreversible by initiators, and change is reversible by promoters. Then sequence, the sequence are applied first and followed by the cancer. Here applied prior to procarcinogen. So these promoters are applied after prior response to initiator. Then efficacy, it is more effective initiators, less effective or not effective at all by promoters. Then molecular change, most common mutation of RAS, oncogen and clonal expansion of mutated cells. The examples of most chemical carcinogens, radiation of the initiators and hormones or formal esters of promoters. Then chemical carcinogens and chemical carcinogenesis. Amongst the chemical carcinogens are divided into two groups, direct acting carcinogens and indirectly acting carcinogens like procarcinogens. They are amongst the direct acting carcinogens, they do not require metabolic activation. And procarcinogens require metabolic activation before becoming potent carcinogens. So amongst the direct acting carcinogens are alkylating agents like cyclophosphamide, anti-cancer drugs like cyclophosphamide, chloramphenicol, busulfan, melphalan and nitrosourea, then beta propiolactone and epoxides. Amongst the alkylating agents are acetyl, imidazole and dimethyl carbamyl chloride. Then indirectly acting carcinogens, procarcinogens require prior metabolic activation before becoming more potent carcinogens. Amongst them are polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons associated with the, it is in the paper of the cigarettes. So polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons examples are anthracene, benzopyrene and methylcholanthrene. And second is aromatic amines or azo dyes used in butter yellow or scarlet red like beta naphthalene and benzidine. Then naturally occurring products like aflatoxin B1, then actinomycin D, mitomycin C, safrol and betel nut. And miscellaneous products, nitrosamines and nitrosamides like vinyl chloride, monomer, asbestos, saccharins and cyclomates. Amongst the direct acting carcinogens and indirect acting carcinogens requiring procarcinogens require metabolic activation. I have told you alkylating agent and acetylating agent. Then indirectly acting, that is procarcinogen, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. Then aromatic amines and azo dyes, naturally occurring products and miscellaneous. I have told in the previous year. This table has been taken from your Hasmohan textbook of pathology. Then amongst the initiators and promoters, I have told you the initiators direct are beta propiolactone, dimethyl sulfate, diepoxy butane, anti-cancer drugs like chloramphenicol, cyclophosphamide, nitrosourea and others, acetylating agent, 1-acetyl imidazole and dimethyl carbamyl chloride. Among the procarcinogen that is indirectly acting requiring metabolic activation are polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, heterocyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, then aromatic amines, amides, azo dyes like scarlet red and butter yellow, then used in as a dye products in the various sweetening agents, sweets. The natural plant and microbial products like aflatoxin B1 causes hepatoma, griseofalvin causes antifungal agents, cycasine from cycads, safrol from sassafras and betel nuts causing oral squamous cell carcinoma. Then among the other carcinogens, initiators are nitrosamine and amides like in tars and nitrites, vinyl chloride, angiosarcoma of Kentucky, then nickel, chromium, insecticide, fungicides and polychlorinated biphenyls. Then chemical carcinogens promoters. दीज प्रोमोटर्स केमिकल कार्सिनोजेंस प्रोमोटर्स इनिशिएटर एंड प्रोमोटर्स दीज कैनॉट एक्ट डायरेक्टली रिक्वायर फर्स्ट इनिशिएटर देन इट प्रोमोट्स कैंसर्स लाइक हॉर्मोन्स फॉर्मल स्टर्स लाइक टीपीए देन एक्टिवेट काइनेज सी फेनॉल्स एंड ड्रग्स These are the chemical carcinogens taken from Robbins textbook, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbon again, direct acting and initiator are direct acting, indirect acting and promoters like TPA, formal esters, safrol, etc. Agents like arsenic, arsenic compound, asbestos, benzene industry causing leukemia, Hodgkin's lymphoma, then beryllium worker, beryllium, cadmium, prostate, chromium, lung carcinoma, nickel, nose and lung carcinoma, radon, lung carcinoma, benign choroid, angiosarcoma and liver cancers. Then biological factors living agents may be parasites like schistosoma, hematobium causes squamous cell carcinoma of the urinary bladder. Similarly, cholinergic sinusitis and liver fluke causes cholangiocarcinoma of the gallbladder. Then fungus, aspergillus flavus causes hepatocellular carcinoma. Then bacteria like Helicobacter pylori causes chronic gastritis and peptic ulcer and in the lung cases causes gastric carcinoma and gastric lymphoma. Then viral, these viral factors, most important organisms for cancer causations like RNA virus and DNA virus. Amongst the DNA virus are humans are human papilloma virus causes cancer cervix, then papilloma virus in animals, then SV40 in humans. Similarly, herpes virus, Epstein-Barr virus causes nasopharyngeal carcinoma and Burkitt lymphoma in children. Then human herpes virus, Kaposi sarcoma virus causes Kaposi sarcoma and pleural effusion lymphoma. Then your pox virus, that is human pox virus like molluscum contagiosum and papilloma virus causes cancers, papillomatosis, which is a predisposing condition for cancers. Then HIP adenoma virus like hepatitis B virus associated with your hepatocellular carcinoma. Similarly, RNA virus like acute transforming virus, it is common in the animals models, slow transforming virus in also animal models. Human T cell lymphotrophic virus are STLV1 and STLV2 that is associated with the lymphoma and leukemia. Hepatitis C virus, retrovirus associated with the hepatocellular carcinoma. Then difference between encoded DNA virus and oncogenic virus. DNA virus, as you know, double stranded. The RNA virus is single stranded. Reverse transcriptase is absent in DNA virus. It is present in RNA virus. Mechanism, DNA virus integrates into the genome of the host cell. The RNA virus transcribes into DNA and then integrates into the host cells. Then mutation rate is low in DNA, mutation rate is high in case of RNA virus. Main protein antigen are T antigen and SRC antigen in RNA virus. Then location, mainly nuclear in case of DNA oncogenic virus, it is in the plasma membrane in the RNA oncogenic virus. Then molecular oncogenesis, the encodes oncoproteins and overgrowth of pro-growth oncogen factors. Then main virus types are hepatitis, human papilloma virus, human Epstein-Barr virus, then Epstein-Barr virus associated with the Burkitt's lymphoma and nasopharyngeal carcinoma, then hepatitis B virus, hepatocellular carcinoma, and hepatitis herpes virus 8 associated with the pleural effusion lymphoma. Similarly, STLV1 and STLV2 associated with the leukemia, STLV1 associated with the non-Hodgkin T-cell lymphoma and STLV2 associated with the T-cell hairy cell leukemia and hepatitis C virus associated with the hepatocellular carcinoma. Then properties of cells transformed by virus are altered cell morphology, fibroblasts become shorter, parallel orientation is lost and chromosomal aberration appears. सेकेंड इज अल्टर्ड सेल मेटाबॉलिज्म, इंक्रीज ग्रोथ रेट, इंक्रीज प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक एसिड एंड एसिड म्यूकोपॉलीसेक्राइड्स, दैट इज वारवर्ग इफेक्ट, आई विल डिस्कस इन मॉलिक्यूलर पैथोजेनेसिस, एंड अल्टर्ड ग्रोथ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, लॉस ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट इनहिबिशन, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ हिप्ड अप ग्रोथ एंड एंटीजेनिक अल्टरेशंस, अपीयरेंस ऑफ न्यू वायरस स्पेसिफिक एंटीजेंस लाइक TSTA, ट्यूमर स्पेसिफिक ट्यूमर एंटीजन, ट्यूमर स्पेसिफिक टी एंटीजन एंड लॉस ऑफ सरफेस एंटीजन्स, कैपेसिटी टू इंड्यूस ट्यूमर्स इन द ससेप्टेबल एनिमल्स. सो दीज आर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द सेल्स ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड बाय वायरस, अल्टर्ड सेल मॉर्फोलॉजी, अल्टर्ड सेल मेटाबॉलिज्म, अल्टर्ड ग्रोथ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, अल्टर्ड एंटीजेनिक कैरेक्टर्स एंड कैपेसिटी टू इंड्यूस इन द ससेप्टेबल एनिमल्स. So this is about the various etiological factor associated with the cancer in the nut cells. That like your predisposing factors, endogenous, exogenous. Amongst the endogenous, age, sex, race, heredity. Exogenous factors, your precancerous lesion, chronic inflammatory states, and certain habits, chewing betel nut, then your Kangri cancer, Chutta cancers, and amongst the precipitating factors are biological factors, physical factors, chemical factors. So these are the precipitating factors. So all about the various etiological factors of the carcinogenesis or etiology of the cancers. In the next class, I will discuss about the molecular biology of the cancer or molecular pathogenesis of the cancer. Thank you.